Today, I'm on my way to Beyond Meat in El Segundo, California, to chat with an engineer working to revolutionize the way we consume meat, an industry plagued with resource inefficiency and health problems.
My name is Lena Pruitt. I'm a chemical engineer. I work for Beyond Meat. There's different kinds of chemical engineering. I'm focused in process engineering. Process engineering is basically understanding how to take materials from their raw ingredients and putting them together in a way that makes sense. We can make a product that looks like meat and cooks like meat.
It's like evolved meat.
Correct.
A lot of people don't realize that there's so much science involved in the food industry.
Science is all about creation, and engineering is all about creation also.
Food is science.
I always say I'm a chemical engineer, so I can make anything. Yeah. I like working with my hands.
Yes.
And that's what's required from an engineer, is you have to be very hands-on, and I have to think about how am I going to move this product into a mixer? How am I going to move this product in and chop it?
Lena, what were some of the challenges that you've overcome in your career?
The biggest challenge for me as a female in a male-dominated industry is believing that a woman can put a machine together. There are females in engineering, but they're a minority.
Do you find that still? You face that sometimes?
Absolutely, and I can handle it now. You have to have a strong personality. You develop that, sometimes you grow up with it, mm-hmm. but also you develop that during your throughout your career and with your education. So,
what advice would you have for little girls who dream of following in your footsteps?
My advice to little girls and young women out there who are interested in science is you will be armed with a very strong tool, which is the tool of science, and that can be applied in many things in life. For me, it opened a lot of doors.
While engineers work to create food for the future, chefs like Brooke Williamson are adapting it onto their menus.
I'm Brooke Williamson. I'm a chef. I've got a few restaurants here in LA. You know, I've spent a lot of years not talking about the fact that I was a female in the kitchen because mm-hmm. I didn't want that to be a topic of discussion. I honestly wanted my skill to prove myself. But to ignore that I am a female in a male-dominated industry would be ignorant. You know, I started cooking professionally at a really, really young age. So I was that, like, 23-year-old girl negotiating a lease, and people looked at me like I had no idea what I was talking about. But I've seen that as a really motivating thing.
It's crazy because it really looks like
real meat. It does. It totally looks like real meat. I think that this touches on so many reasons why red meat is not a necessary component to a menu. I've seen partnerships between plant-based products and very well-known chefs over the last year more than I've seen over the last 10 years.
As our global population continues to grow, we need more engineers creating out-of-the-box solutions to feed our planet.